Our internet's Anathon. Christ our King is coming. He is the Lamb foretold by John. In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Good morning.
Good morning, Father.
And welcome. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. I confess to Almighty God and to you, my brothers and sisters, that I have greatly sinned in my thoughts and in my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do, through my most grievous fault. Therefore, I ask Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, all the angels and saints, and you, my brothers and sisters, to pray for me to the Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us of our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Let us pray. Grant, we pray, Almighty God, that we who are weighed down from of old by slavery beneath the yoke of sin may be set free by the newness of the long-awaited nativity of your only begotten Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Jeremiah. Behold, the days are coming, says the Lord, when I will raise up a righteous shoot to David. As king he shall reign and govern wisely. He shall do what is just and right in the land. In his days Judah shall be saved. Israel shall dwell in security. This is the name they give him: the Lord our justice. Therefore the days will come, says the Lord, when they shall no longer say, as the Lord lives, who brought the children of Israel out of the land of Egypt? But rather, as the Lord lives, who brought the descendants of the house of Israel up from the land of the north? And from all the lands to which I banished them, they shall again live on their own land. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
O God, with your judgment endow the king, and with your justice the king's son. He shall govern your people with justice, and your afflicted ones with judgment. For he shall rescue the poor when he cries out, and the afflicted when he has no one to help him. He shall have pity for the lowly and the poor. The lives of the poor he shall save.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and fullness of peace forever.
Blessed be the Lord, the God of Israel, who alone does wondrous deeds, and blessed forever be his glorious name. May the whole earth be filled with his glory.
Justice shall flourish in his time, and the fullness of peace forever.
Alleluia.
The house of Israel, give the law to Moses on Sinai. Come to rescue us with your mighty power. Alleluia.
Alleluia. Alleluia.
The Lord be with you.
A
reading of the Holy Gospel according to Matthew. Glory to you, O Lord. This is how the birth of Jesus came about. When his mother Mary was betrothed to Joseph, before they lived together, she was found with child through the Holy Spirit. Joseph, her husband, since he was a righteous man, yet unwilling to expose her to shame, decided to divorce her quietly. Such was his intention when, behold, the angel of the Lord appeared to him in a dream and said, "Joseph, son of David, do not be afraid to take Mary, your wife, into your home. For it is through the Holy Spirit this child has been conceived in her. She will bear a son, and you are to name him Jesus, because he will save his people from their sins." All this took place to fulfill what the Lord had said through the prophets. "Behold, the virgin shall be with child and bear a son, and they shall name him Emmanuel," which means God is with us. When Joseph awoke, he did as the angel Lord had commanded him and took his wife into his home. He had no relations with her until she bore a son and named him Jesus. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
There's such mystery around the mystery of Joseph. It really is gift to look at Joseph and to be so encouraged, to have that courage. You see, so many times we say to ourselves, these saints had all these revelations, God told them exactly what to do, and they listened and they followed. And now, only if God would tell me. I'm not hearing, I'm not listening, I'm not seeing, I'm not receiving. And then we get so frustrated. Or if God reveals something and God says something and it's too much, we want to run. But what Joseph is trying to teach us is to be aware that God is in our midst. That God is with us, God is in us, and God is through us, and God is communicating something to us every day. There is a message. To listen and to see. And whatever the message is, God will bring you to it, God will bring you through it, and God will give you all the grace.
As Joseph so beautifully gave his bride to God first, every time there was evil, they fled, stayed away, completely away. And at every struggle, they embrace more in faith and love and devotion to God. You see, Joseph teaches us what it means to be people of faith. And what blessed gift. And so I pray as we bring this Advent season to a close, as we move into the Christmas season, that all that's around us and all that we're saturated with is not consuming us. And I pray that's why we're here today, and I pray that's why we pray that we believe that God has a message. That we believe that God is saying something. And that we listen and hear, and that we have the faith that's Joseph to say yes and to believe and to never doubt. And to have one mission in our life. That everything, about everything, is following a God. And never doubting that God. And remaining faithful to that God. And knowing He's got it. He's got it. And longing for that day when we can be with St. Joseph in heaven forever and ever. Amen. Let us now stand and turn our prayers and petitions before the very throne of grace. We pray for the Holy Father, Pope Francis. We pray for the Archbishop, George Lucas. And we pray for this entire church. That we will be a vessel that helps everyone see the face of God, helps everyone hear His voice, and respond to His message with great faith, great love, and great devotion. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for this archdiocese, all of Father Stephen Gutzel's parishioners that are mourning his loss, for all the brother priests that are burying their brother today, that the good Lord will bless his soul. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray in great gratitude and great joy and great thanksgiving for this beautiful parish of St. Wenceslaus and all the beautiful souls that make this parish so absolutely beautiful with their time, talent, and treasure. We continue to pray for our mission, our work, our school, that we continue to be a beacon of light, of hope and love in West Omaha. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray in great joy and great gratitude and great thanksgiving to Almighty God that He would create such beautiful men and women with such beautiful gifts, talents, and skills, and these men and women would choose to use them to defend our freedom. We pray for our military. We pray for those that are in dangerous deployments and missions and operations, and those that got to be separated from their family this Christmas. That the warmth, comfort, love of our prayers will give them strength and encouragement. We pray for our veterans, especially our homeless veterans that are lost, lonely, scared, and afraid. We will get them all the aid, love, and assistance they need from a grateful nation. And we pray with our hearts just moved beyond measure for those that die in the line of duty to defend our freedom. That every day we are grateful and thankful for their service, and we pray for their soul that it's resting in the hands of Almighty God. And for the thousands and thousands of bodies we're still trying to find and recover, they'll be found and united back to their families. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. We pray for our beloved sick, And we pray for those that are dying, especially the families that are looking for a priest this day, that a good and faithful priest will get that call and drop everything and go to that bedside and hold the soul in his hand and give it an apostolic pardon and prepare it to meet the Lord this very day. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And for all of your thoughts and all of your prayers and all of your petitions you so beautifully hold this beautiful morning in the beautiful silence of your beautiful heart. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. And we pray for the intention of our Catholic daughters for whom this Mass is being offered. And we pray in great gratitude and great joy and great thanksgiving for all the good they do in our parish. For this we pray to the Lord. Lord, hear our prayer. Good and gracious God, blessed are we to come to this beautiful chapel, to be with our beautiful family, and to be like our beautiful Saint Joseph, to listen, to hear, to see, and to follow, and to know you have a plan for us. In faith and love, we make all of these prayers through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread we offer you, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life. Blessed be God forever. Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer you, fruit of the vine and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink. Blessed be God forever. Pray, my brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice of your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May this sacrifice be offered to you, O Lord. Make us acceptable to your name. We merit for all eternity to be the companions of Christ, by whose death our own mortality was healed, who lives and reigns forever and ever.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is
truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For all the oracles the prophets foretold him, the Virgin Mother longed for him with love beyond all telling. John the Baptist sang of his coming and proclaimed his presence when he came. It is by his gift that already we rejoice at the mystery of his nativity, so he may find us watchful in prayer, exultant in his praise. And so with the angels and archangels, with the thrones and dominions, with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end. We acclaim, Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion. He took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith. We proclaim your death, O Lord, and profess your resurrection until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life in the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and George, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever. Amen. At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, "Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us, and lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ. Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world, have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb. Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Our communion anthem, his name will be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. Let us pray. May we receive your mercy in the midst of your temple, O Lord, and show fitting honor to the coming solemnities of our redemption through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Make sure we take notice tomorrow that Mass is at 8:15, not 8:30. 8:15 tomorrow, Mass. Change of time. The Lord be with you.
And
may Almighty God bless you, in the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go in peace. Thanks be to God.